Well, the first no-charge solar-powered car is being developed right here in San Diego. Heather Lake, live in Sorrento Valley with the look. Heather, I'm beyond fascinated. Let me see this thing.
Oh, I'm sure. Yeah. So this is what it looks like. Okay. Super cool. We're going to introduce you to Aptera Motors this morning. Basically, if you want a car that looks like it is from the future, this is it. But this is what's going to be on the roads very, very soon. So we're going to talk to one of the co-founders here, Steve Fambro of Aptera Motors. This is so cool. And I know a lot of people may have been seeing this as you guys are a startup with rounds of investments coming through. But this is something that I'm like, man, like this is really going to be on the road soon. And I think people want to be ready for it, and also something that they don't have to fill up with gas. Our gas prices are crazy right now. So let's talk about this, Steve. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
By the way, we see the solar powers panels on the front. You will have to eventually plug it in at some point, but how does the technology work on this?
Yeah, well, Aptera is a solar electric vehicle company. So unlike a regular EV that you plug in, you only have to plug this in if you go on long trips. For most people, between 20 and 40 miles a day of free charging will come from the sun, just from the solar panels that are built in the vehicle.
So 40 miles, it'll go on that. And then basically this thing can go 1,000 miles on a charge though, which is a really long time. I mean, if you look at some of the other EV vehicles, you get 250 to 300.
Yeah, we have four range options. So 250, 400, 600, and 1,000. 400 has been the most popular. We pre-sold over 10,000 vehicles, and we're averaging about 100 a day, or about 30,000 a year as a reservation rate. 400 is the most popular, but the largest one, you can go up to 1,000 miles.
Let's talk about performance. Obviously, it looks a little different than your normal four-wheeled car. So this obviously, it has three wheels. Does it drive nicely, or is it kind of like a really nice golf cart?
Well, you're going to go drive one in just a minute.
Okay.
But this one is 0 to 60 in less than 4 seconds.
Oh, wow.
It's actually quite fast.
Okay. And we've got a lot of cameras and things going on inside. Obviously, this one is not turned on this morning. We're going to get in some of the newer vehicles later on to see that. But let's talk about some of the technology behind just the bells and whistles of the car.
Yeah, you've got, as you said, cameras that give you a full 360 or 180 degree view of the rear so that you don't have to take your eyes off the road to really build a good situational awareness. The cameras are also part of the ADAS system, which provides level 2 driving autonomy. And then, of course, you have a main control screen inside, which lets you use all the features of the vehicle, from air conditioning to entertainment, everything else.
It looks cool, right? Like when you were getting together with your friend, who's also the co-founder, Chris, and you decided to create this, were you like, we've got to make this look futuristic? Is that the idea behind some of this? Is like, we want something different? Or is it the streamline of it just works for the way that the car, operates?
Yeah, it's really the latter. It's all about math and science. So we wanted a vehicle platform that would use the least amount of energy so we could use the fewest number of batteries possible, because we want to make EVs affordable, and batteries are the most expensive part. So in order to do that, we had to really lower the drag coefficient of the vehicle, which is why it has the streamlined shape.
Yeah, I'm fascinated. It looks very like a fifth element, kind of, you know. It's super cool. Can I sit down inside? I want to see, you know, how it feels, how it looks. You know, would I look good in this car riding around in it? Can we talk too about the panels? This is different solar than what we're used to seeing kind of in our houses. Like if someone has solar on their roof, this is a lot different.
Yeah, most people are used to seeing flat solar panels on the roof, like you said. But here we have individual solar cells that are flexible in both directions, and they're bonded to the parts. So on the hood and on the roof and on the rear, the solar panels take on curvature in both directions and integrate with electronics to charge the vehicle up to about 40 miles per day.
So you guys are not only creating this car to be efficient and kind of awesome for the environment, but also it takes a lot less work to put one of these guys together. Obviously, you're going to be developing, building them here in San Diego. How many parts are in a normal car compared to what this is?
Well, the main body structure of a typical passenger car has about 200 parts.
Wow.
And they all have to be affixed and welded together. This vehicle has less than 10. And they mechanically key together like Legos, sort of. So it helps in the assembly, and it makes it less capital intensive, which is one of the reasons we're able to do it here in San Diego.
Okay, Steve, you and Chris have been very busy during the pandemic, as some people who stayed working have been. This is the first prototype. The second one is just launched. We're gonna show that in the next hour. By the way, Raul, I feel like I'm kind of, the seats
yes.
feel very Formula One style.
Yes.
Like it's very performance, kind of race car-ish. So you're in this like futuristic race car. Really quick, one last question. Is this thing gonna have wings in the future? Like, do we have plans to make it fly?
Like a little plan.
No, we don't want it to fly. We want it to stay firmly on the ground.
Yeah.
Okay. So plan is to keep it on the ground for now at least.
probably smart. I had a question about the panels. I'm assuming those things last for a long time, or like, do you have to replace them if you get dinged by like the rocks and pebbles as you're driving? Can you replace them, interchange them? How long do they last?
Ooh, that's a good idea. So talk about the lasting, kind of the lifeline and lifetime of the panels. Like, say, you know, you get a rock or you get in an accident or whatever, do they last long, or how is it replacing them?
Yeah, a couple of interesting things about these solar cells. So it's a new technology, it's very efficient, and it's actually able to continue to function even if it's cracked or broken.
Oh.
But as the panels degrade over the life of the vehicle, or as they get more efficient, you might want to upgrade and get more miles per charge, maybe 30 or 40 or 50 or 60 miles. So as that efficiency increases, the panels are replaceable. So you can order new ones and they just install, replace the other ones,
cool.
And you're back on the road.
Okay.
Cool.
I know, I like it.
But can you drive it over? You're not that far. Drive it over to Kearney Mesa. You don't need to tell them. And then I'll do a spin and then you take it back. Easy.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, not going to happen.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, Heather, thank you. You enjoy that. We'll talk to you a little bit later on.